Is your PC acting strange? Crashing, freezing, or showing errors you can't fix in normal mode? Safe mode is your secret weapon, but only if you know how to get there. In this video, we'll show you every reliable method to boot into safe mode in Windows 10, whether your system works fine or won't even start. Let's dive in and take control. Hello everyone, and welcome to the CNADD channel. Safe mode is a diagnostic mode in Windows that loads only the essential drivers and services, making it easier to troubleshoot and resolve system issues. If Windows starts normally, use method 1, 2, or 3. If Windows fails to boot, use method 4. If you're a power user and need deeper control over safe mode settings, don't miss method 5. Method 1. Enter safe mode from the Windows desktop or sign-in screen. Open the Start menu. Select Power. Press and hold the Shift key, then click Restart. The computer will reboot into the Windows recovery environment. If you're on the sign-in screen, you can also access this option. Click Power, hold down the Shift key, and select Restart. In the recovery screen, select Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, Startup Settings, Restart. Now you'll see three main options to enter safe mode. Press 4 to enable safe mode. This loads only the essential system files and services. Press 5 to enable safe mode with networking. This also includes network drivers and services, which is useful if you need internet access while troubleshooting. Note, in safe mode with networking, only a wired internet connection, Ethernet, is typically available. Wi-Fi support is usually disabled in this mode. Press 6 to enable safe mode with command prompt. This gives you access to a command line interface instead of the regular desktop. For most situations, safe mode with networking is the best option as it gives you basic functionality aligned with internet access, which can be helpful when searching for solutions online or downloading tools. Choose the option that best fits your needs by pressing the corresponding number key on your keyboard. After that, your computer will restart automatically. Once it boots up, sign into your account and you'll be taken straight into safe mode. To exit safe mode, simply restart your computer. It will boot back into normal Windows mode. Tip: if you choose option 6 and boot into safe mode with command prompt, you can still access the standard desktop using this trick. From command prompt, simply type Explorer and press Enter. This will attempt to launch the Windows desktop environment directly. Using Task Manager, if you close the command prompt window or it doesn't appear, press Ctrl-Alt-Delete, open Task Manager, then go to the File menu and select Run New Task. In the dialog box that appears, type Explorer and press Enter. Note, this only works if system files like explorer.exe are intact. If your system is severely damaged, the desktop may fail to launch. In that case, continue troubleshooting from the command prompt. Method 2. Enter safe mode from Windows settings. Right-click the Start button and choose Settings, or press Windows key I on your keyboard to open the Settings app. Go to Update and Security, Recovery. To continue, look for the Advanced Startup section. The Restart Now button should be located just below it. Click Restart Now. Your PC will now reboot into the Windows recovery environment where you can access tools like Startup Settings to enter safe mode. Navigate to Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, Startup Settings, Restart. On the Startup Settings screen, press one of the numbers 4, 5, or 6 on your keyboard based on the options we explained earlier. We recommend choosing 5, Safe Mode with Networking, which is commonly used for troubleshooting while still having internet access. After that, your computer will restart automatically. Once it boots up, sign into your account and you'll be taken straight into safe mode. To exit safe mode, simply restart your computer. It will boot back into normal Windows mode. Method 3. Enter safe mode using command prompt. Open the Start menu, type CMD, right-click on command prompt, and select Run as Administrator. Type the following command and press Enter. Shutdown space slash R space slash O. After a short moment, your PC will reboot into the Windows recovery environment. Go to Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, Startup Settings, Restart. Then select your preferred safe mode option. After that, your computer will restart automatically. Once it boots up, sign into your account and you'll be taken straight into safe mode. To exit safe mode, simply restart your computer. It will boot back into normal Windows mode. There's another way to boot into safe mode using command prompt. This method modifies the boot configuration. Open command prompt as administrator. Type the following command and press enter. bcdedit space slash set space open curly brace boot mgr close curly brace space display boot menu space yes. After press enter, you should see this confirmation message. The operation completed successfully. This means the settings has been applied correctly. You can also find this command in the video description. Now restart your computer. Windows will now display the boot menu with a short countdown timer every time the system starts, even if there's only one operating system installed. From the boot menu, select your operating system, usually Windows 10, and press the F8 key to access the advanced startup options. On the startup settings screen, press one of the numbers 4, 5, or 6 on your keyboard based on the options we explained earlier. After that, your computer will restart automatically. Once it boots up, sign into your account and you'll be taken straight into safe mode. To exit safe mode, simply restart your computer. It will boot back into normal Windows mode. To stop Windows from showing the boot menu every time your PC starts, disable it with this command. Open command prompt as administrator. Type the following command and press enter. bcdedit space slash set space open curly brace boot mgr close curly brace space display boot menu space no. Restart your computer. Windows will now boot normally without displaying the boot menu. Method 4. Enter safe mode when Windows doesn't boot properly. If Windows fails to start normally, you can force it into recovery mode using the physical power button. Here's how to do it. Make sure your computer is completely turned off. Turn it on, and as soon as you see the Windows or manufacturer's logo, press and hold the power button until it shuts down. Repeat this process 2 or 3 times. After multiple failed boot attempts, Windows will automatically enter the recovery environment. Note, on our test laptop, we had to repeat this process 4 times before the recovery environment appeared. Depending on your system, it may only take 2 or 3 times. Try it out and see what works for your device. From there, navigate to Troubleshoot, Advanced Options, Startup Settings, Restart. On the next screen, choose one of the safe mode options by pressing the appropriate number key. For most users, pressing 5 to select safe mode with networking is the best option as it provides internet access for downloading tools or searching for solutions. However, if your system doesn't boot properly with this option, try pressing 4 for basic safe mode or 6 to use safe mode with command prompt. After that, your computer will restart automatically. Once it boots up, sign into your account and you'll be taken straight into safe mode. To exit safe mode, simply restart your computer. It will boot back into normal Windows mode. Method 5. Advanced methods for power users using msconfig and command prompt boot configuration. For advanced users who want more control over safe mode, here are two powerful methods you can use to boot into safe mode persistently until you decide to switch back. Note, these methods are recommended only for experienced users who are comfortable modifying system boot configurations. Use caution and make sure you know how to revert changes to avoid being stuck in safe mode. Option 1. Using System Configuration or MSConfig. Open the Start menu, type MSConfig, and open the System Configuration app. Go to the Boot tab. Check the box for Safe Boot and select either Minimal for basic safe mode without networking or Network if you need safe mode with networking support. Click Apply, then OK. Click Restart to boot straight into safe mode. Keep in mind, if you don't undo this setting, your computer will keep booting into safe mode every time it starts. To exit safe mode using msconfig, open msconfig again. Go to the Boot tab, uncheck Safe Boot, click Apply and OK. Restart your computer to boot normally. Option 2. Using Command Prompt Boot Configuration. Open Command Prompt as administrator. Type the following command and press Enter. bcd edit /set /open curly brace current (close curly brace) /safe boot /network. If you want to boot into safe mode without networking, check out this command on the screen. Restart your computer. Your system will boot into safe mode with or without networking depending on your choice. This settings forces Windows to always boot into safe mode until you disable it. To disable and return to normal boot, open command prompt as administrator again. Type the following command and press enter. bcd edit /delete value /open curly brace (current close curly brace) /safe boot. Restart your computer and Windows will boot normally. Thanks for watching. Now you know exactly how to boot into safe mode in Windows 10, no matter what situation you're in. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to the channel for more clear and practical Windows tutorials.